Chronicon is a nice ARPG which offers some necromancy and demonology. For this you need to choose a warlock class. The warlock has four different schools of magic which offer a variety of direct damage spells, debuffs and minions. The magic schools are Corruption, Lich, Demonology and Reaper. Corruption is all about poison. It has a lot of different damage spells for poison, but since this is the Cheb Gurnaz channel, we're just going to focus on the minions here. The minion spells offered by the Corruption School are Zombie and Living Blood. Zombies are permanent minions and you get just a few of them at the beginning. Whenever they die, a new one appears near you and throws itself back into the fray. This all happens without you having to do anything, so it's kind of a set and forget type of spell. The zombies deal a percentage of your overall poison damage as their own damage. As you kill stuff, you'll occasionally get a soul. These souls can be spent to empower your spells, and if you don't use them, they disappear pretty quickly. When used with the zombie skill, the zombies will vomit poisonous stuff on enemies. The zombie can be upgraded with the pestilence skill, which causes the zombies to apply damage over time effects to the enemies they attack. It can be further upgraded with the horde skill, which grants some extra zombies for however many souls you have currently stored. Living Blood is a skill that gives your poison attacks a chance to spawn a timed, temporary minion called a Living Blood. These creatures explode on death in a poisonous area of effect. There may be a third kind of minion called the Plague Bearer. It's hinted at in the Masteries, which I'll talk about later, but I haven't been able to find it for the life of me. The Lich School of Magic is all about ice magic. It offers no minions, so it's of no use to me, but you might like it. The final ability is called Lich Form, which transforms your character into a lich for 20 seconds. Demonology is all about fire magic, and it also lets you summon some demons and devils. The first minion ability is one where you must decide between little imps or little devils. They have slightly different stats. I believe the imps are squishier but deal more damage, and the devils are tougher but deal less damage. It could be the other way around though. In any case, I went with the little devils. The little devils are permanent minions that work similarly to the zombies, in that you get a few of them and they're permanent. If they die, new ones appear without you having to do anything. They deal fire damage, and if you sacrifice a soul with this ability, the little devils will all cast Fire Nova. The little devils can be upgraded to explode on death with the Volatile skill. The Demonic Strength skill increases companion health and damage by 10% for each soul you hold. This buff should also benefit your other minions like the zombies. The final ability in Demonology is either the ability to transform into a demon for a short time, or to summon one. Of course I chose the summon. It gives you a powerful demon unit that runs around casting fire magic for 20 seconds before exploding in a fiery death. Finally, we come to the Reaper school of magic. Reaper is all about shadow damage and spooky stuff like curses. For the minion abilities, it offers you the Ritual of Necromancy, which gives a 25% chance to spawn a skeleton when you kill something. This skeleton can be an archer or a spearman. The skeletons are timed and last for 20 or 30 seconds, and are capped at 5 skeletons. If you sacrifice a soul with this spell, all 5 skeletons will appear immediately. The ultimate skill in this school offers either a Vampire Lord transformation for 20 seconds, or a Death Knight transformation for 20 seconds. In addition to the minions granted by skills, you can also get some from equipment. I found a ring that gave me a goblin companion whenever I wore it, as well as another item that granted me a hellhound. Sadly, as I leveled up, I had to ditch these items in favour of superior equipment, but I held onto them for far longer than was sensible. My hellhound item was like a level 20 item, and I was still using it by the time I was level 60. As you fight and level up, experience will go into a thing called Masteries. The Masteries have a separate experience bar and increase at a different rate to your normal experience. There is a line of perks for each school of magic. Most of them are about buffing or changing your damage spells, but a few of them benefit your minions. The first Mastery in the Corruption line is called Hardened Companions and will buff your minions' health for each point invested. Further down the line there's some skills that tweak the Zombie and Plague Bearer minions. For example, this one fuses them into one minion. Now I've got no idea where this Plague Bearer minion comes from. I've read the skills over and over and I've never found it, but it must be in there somewhere. I'm sorry I haven't been able to inform you about this minion, beyond just mentioning it. There's also a couple that change how living blood works. The Reaper line is where most of the minion stuff comes from. The first skill buffs minion damage. When you max it out, your minions will deal 40% more damage, which is very worthwhile. Further along is the Wraith Mastery, which changes how your Ritual of Necromancy works. If you choose it, your Ritual of Necromancy will no longer summon skeletons, but instead summons one Wraith. The Wraith is powerful and has a few different spells. I chose this option because I love Wraiths, and the Wraith in this looks very cool. It reminds me of the One of Many from Neverwinter Nights 2. In essence, you're trading quantity for quality, but I'd recommend you stick with whatever minion you prefer and not worry about it too much. My overall opinion of this game is high. Minion gameplay is quite well supported. I was concerned at first because my minions started out incredibly weak, so weak that they were hardly noticeable. I'm a little over level 70 now though, and with all the various masteries and perks that buff minions, as well as some equipment that buffs them, they are very strong. They deal the majority of the damage, and if I want to, I can certainly sit back and do nothing, letting them tear the enemy to pieces. This even works against bosses. For example, in this fight, I decided to do nothing and just let the minions mess them up. They do a fine job, but it does go by a little quicker if you decide to pitch in. As a side note unrelated to the minion gameplay, it has this mechanic a bit like in Diablo 3, where you're encouraged to kill everything as fast as possible. There's this little yellow bar, and every time you kill an enemy within a couple of seconds, it gets bumped up. When the killing stops, you're rewarded with money and experience depending on how high that kill count is. You may like this, but I personally do not. It makes me feel pressured to do things as quickly as possible all the time, so I don't miss out on that extra XP, which distracts me from appreciating where I am in the game. I'm scoring this game an 8.2 out of 10 for its minion mechanics. This is the first game which is being scored with my new scoring system, in case you're wondering why it's different. You can read about why I changed it on my community page on YouTube. To break it down, the minions are plentiful, and you've got a mixture of permanent and time minions. The minions are quite useful, although they start out very weak, and I feel that they are not as useful as they are in other similar games like Diablo 2, Grim Dawn, and Path of Exile, where they are stronger than you from the get-go, and you really rely on them being there. There are, from what I can tell, 7 permanent minions, 3 zombies, and 4 devils, so 7 points there. The minion diversity is good. You have quite the variety of minions to choose from, although most of that diversity is with the timed ones, which is unfortunate. Thanks for watching. I hope this video has been informative, and if you are considering this game for its minion gameplay, that you now have a better idea of what to expect. I've got more Necromancy videos coming soon.